नमस्ते एंड गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल एंड होप टू सी यू ऑल इन गुड कंडीशन एंड प्रैक्टिसिंग लाइफ टेक्निक्स एवरी डे। एंड टुडे इज़ अ वार्मर डे देन यस्टरडे, इट्स गेटिंग टू हॉट आउटसाइड, सो कीप योर सेल्फ सेफ। एंड टुडे इज एवरी टाइम आई रिपीट, आई एम रीडिंग द बुक ऑफ सीक्रेट्स, दैट इज़ विज्ञान भैरव तंत्र, which has been translated by Osho, and I love the way he has translated. But wherever you are going to find Vigyan Bhairav Tantra translated by any spiritual leader, it is one and the same thing. Only the difference comes up when people are explaining in the way they have understood. So I try to make you all understand the way I have understood. And today we are going to start. I don't know how many I'll be able to cover, but I'll try to cover two or maybe one. And this is the Inner Centering Sutra, and this is going to be the 18th Sutra since we have started from the Book of Secrets, the Vigyan Bhairav Tantra. So this is a beautiful sutra, and this leads you and teaches you how to get centered, how to get centered inside. And you can try to get centering while practicing this technique. And I would like to, before starting this, I would like to tell you more about few things so that you can remember while you are performing or using this technique. We are having five sense organs. You know, we have our eyes to see, we have our nose to smell, we have our ears to hear, we taste from our tongue, and we can feel through our own body. So I would just, before starting this centering sutra, I would like to, I would like you all to just, you just experiment, or maybe just do a small activity with me, a small exercise with me. So you just need to close your eyes and think about something which is there in your room. Maybe if you are sitting on a dining table or on a sofa, or if something is nearby you, anything you can take up, or you can just recall any of your relative or your mother. So just close your eyes and try to see your mother. So are you able to see your mother? Great. Now let us experiment with our ears, okay? So try to or recall the voice of your mom. So close your eyes and try to recall the voice of your mom inside you. Are you able to hear the voice of your mom? Now you yourself give yourself a, maybe a call, maybe your name, whatever your name is. So call yourself. So I'm closing my eyes and I'm going to call myself. So yes, I can hear myself. Okay, next, I want you all to again close your eyes and try to recall the smell of maybe a freshly made chapati, or smell when it rains, and smell which we all love, the earthen smell. So I hope you are able to collect the smell from the experiences you have already exposed to. Okay, now comes the next thing. I want you all to feel snow. Close your eyes and feel as if snow is falling around you. Try to feel the coldness of snow. There are mountains and mountains of snow around you. Try to feel the coldness which comes out from the snow. It's a very small experiment. What I realize is the eyes are given to you as a medium, and you see someone somewhere inside. It is not here. This is just given to you to see. And when you heard someone's voice, what was about it? You were hearing the voice somewhere inside. You were able to smell what I asked you to, somewhere inside. And what I asked you to feel also came from inside. But what we do, we create obstacles. These are the five windows given to us to collect experiences, to collect different experiences of knowing this world around us, knowing people around us, experiencing different things. But we feel that we are experiencing it here, we are experiencing it here, we are experiencing it here. No, we are experiencing it deep inside at our center. And sometimes you must have seen, we are engrossed in some activity and after that we feel good. Maybe you are hearing a music and then after some time when you keep hearing it, you feel, oh, I am feeling blissful. So is it the music which you have heard here makes you feel blissful? No, my friends. Something which has happened at your center makes you feel blissful. You feel the bliss at your center. If you are doing something, if you are doing some activity, if you have seen a child playing and engrossed in the activity and you find the child happy, so you feel that this activity makes the child happy. And again, we go wrong. It is not the activity which is making the child happy. It is something which has happened inside and the person or the child got connected to the center is what is giving him the bliss. But we don't do like this. We start judging, start bringing our head in between and all those experiences vanish off. And it becomes so difficult for us to remain at our center. So let me read few lines for you all. You are listening to a music and someone says, I feel very blissful. But if constantly you are directly concerned with bliss, you will not even be able to listen. That concern, that greed for bliss will become a barrier. Bliss is a byproduct. You cannot grab it directly. It is so delicate a phenomenon that you have to approach it only indirectly. Do something else and it happens. You cannot do it directly. So without all these senses, we cannot experience also. And senses, we get stuck in the senses itself. But after doing something and touching our center, we reach our bliss. And these techniques help us directly to connect to our center. So nothing happens, nothing, there is no as such a real spiritual happening, no technique which gives you a spiritual happening. You have to do something. You have to, that is why n number of spiritual leaders, they keep on saying that do your sadhana daily. You cannot just sit and have that bliss and there will be, it happens spontaneously, anytime it happens. And if you want things to happen, maybe spiritually, if you want the bliss to happen, you need to try these sutras and slowly you can connect yourself, you can be blissful. So this 18th sutra is something which I like, and this sutra says, look lovingly at an object. So this sutra says that you have to keep watching an object with your whole body, with everything. Try to smell the object, try to feel the object and keep on watching the object. I have just updated this version. I say you can include this sutra throughout the day. Just keep on watching people, your world, whatever is happening lovingly. And everything is going to turn up well. And you'll be connected with the center. So try to have equal eyes for whatever happens around you. It can be good. It can be bad. You may find few things dirty, ugly. And you may find few things beautiful and mesmerizing. The sutra says, just look around lovingly. And slowly, slowly, this love takes you within. When eyes are watching something, it is not always 100% sure that we watch someone lovingly. Sometimes being human, lust also enters in us. But when you watch someone with lust, the person becomes an object. The person is no more there. If a husband looks her wife or a girlfriend with lust, then the girlfriend or the wife becomes a thing to be used, utilized. But if he or she is watching him lovingly, with eyes of love, then suddenly you are thrown towards your center. The world outside, these senses which are given to us, help us to reach our center. So let me read few lines here. Love makes anything unique. That is why without love, you never feel like a person. Unless someone loves you deeply, you never feel that you have any uniqueness. You are just one in a crowd, just a number. You cannot be changed. Dear friends, there are hundreds of people out there. There are cinema stars, there are celebrities. There is a common teacher also, like me. There is a common mother. There are a number of people working out there. And what makes them special, what gives them their living life importance, is having love in their life. We love all those celebrities. Thousands and thousands of people are fans. See, we are remembering an actor who has passed away yesterday, and today also there is an actor. And there are fans who are tremendously sad. And they are so sad that they don't feel like doing anything because it is the love he has gained from the crowd. You require that you don't need thousands and thousands of people to love you. You just need one person to make a difference in your life. And if some one person loves you 100%, you become special. A maid coming in your house, if is loved by someone special, becomes very special. She feels confident and she feels as if she's the most beautiful woman on the earth. So, if you are loved, if you are treasured, then you become special. That is the difference between a crowd and you. And mind you, if we are teachers or if we are employees, we are serving some institute, and then we know we are there no more. Someone is going to replace us. We have done the death meditation also. But if someone loves you deeply, and if then death takes up, then one cannot be replaced in his or her life. If I love someone and if death takes him away, I cannot replace him by anyone else. So love is different. And the sutra says, love around, love the objects around you, and you just have to see them lovingly, look at them lovingly, and you have seen the spiritual masters who have achieved. They always are so loving. You find them watching everything, talking, walking, and you find them mesmerizing and loving. When they touch, when they bless you with their hands, you find them loving. And suddenly what happens? The byproduct of this watching the real world around you with love leads you to the center of your whole body. You reach to the center, you are thrown to the center, and then you feel blissful. So if you are the person who is in love, or if you're the person who is being loved, both are thrown towards the center. So the sutra is one of the most beautiful sutra, and let me read if this helps any one of you here. Every husband and every wife, they are creating hell for each other because each one is trying to possess the other. Possession is possible only with things, never with persons. You can only be possessed by a person. You can never possess a person. A thing can be possessed, but you try to possess person. Though that effort person becomes thing, if I make you into a thing, you will react. Then I am your enemy. Then you will try to make a thing out of me. That creates hell. So in relationship, if we try to possess the person, our spouse, then the person is no more a person. The person becomes an object. And that is the thing which kills the love between husband and wife or in relationships. You are sitting in your room alone, and then suddenly you become aware that someone is peeping through the keyhole. Observe minutely what happens. Have you felt any change? And why do you feel angry about this peeping? Some means, maybe we can name him Tom. He's not doing anything to you, just peeping. Why do you feel angry? He has changed you into a thing. He's observing, he has made you into a thing, into an object. And that gives you an uneasiness. And we all face this. If we go anywhere, if someone stares at us straight away and keep on looking, and we start feeling that uneasiness within us. And why this uneasiness is there within us? Because we start feeling that we are taken as an object and we are being looked upon through lust, and that gives us uneasiness. And if someone, that person is your mother or the person you are in love with, and that person looks at you continuously with love, you are able to person is looking at you with love or with lust. You can do it consciously also. And when you do it consciously, it goes deeper, because then you are not obsessed with the object. This is happening every day. If you love someone, you feel blissful not because of him or her, but because of love. And why because of love? Because this phenomenon happens and this sutra happens. And sometimes people take this sutra something like weirdo. They keep on collecting things throughout their life. The whole house is stuffed with all over the shits. So I don't say that start loving the things around you. No, I am not telling you that, nor even the sutra means it. So what you have to do is take a moment and select something, and to do it intentionally, take a flower or sit near a tree and start observing that tree lovingly. And soon that tree is going to dissolve and become a person. And do this sutra, try practicing it. Now it can happen with a rose, it can happen with a rock, it can happen with trees, it can happen with anything. Once you know the situation in which it happens, it can happen anywhere. If you know that you are not, and with a deep love, your consciousness has moved to the other, to the trees, to the sky, to the stars, to anyone, when your total consciousness is addressed to the other, it leaves you. It moves away from you. In that absence is the self, is the blessing. So though this sutra says that look at sky and stone and trees, it is easier. But when you look people around you, whom you don't love even, they feel the blessing. So I say, try to watch lovingly people around you. You know this, if you want to prove yourself how to watch lovingly. So just observe your own child playing. Just look at him without judging. Though this has entered in the parents also, they don't look at their child lovingly. They keep on judging what he's doing. He's poking his nose, or he's spilling, or he's throwing things out there. He's not taking care of himself. He has not taken bath. Blah, blah, blah. Don't watch their child also lovingly. Love your children. Just observe. Look at them lovingly. And then then something is going to enter you and you will feel the bliss. So try this sutra, and I think we can cover one more. So I'll cover one more. This is also good. Sit. This is the 19th sutra of centering, and this says that sit on your buttocks only. And when you see Mahavira or when you see a sculpture or Buddha sitting straight, and you see that they are just sitting straight, you never understand where to take awareness. When I meditate with my students out there, they say where to concentrate, where to take my attention. So in this sutra, if you are following this sutra says so nice, sit on your buttocks only. Now trying this sutra, you need to do one small exercise for a week. So this exercise is all about your hand. So you need to start taking your whole attention towards your right hand for 3 continuous days. Okay, so this you will do. Once you are going to take this your whole attention to your right hand for 3 days, so you are closing your eyes, and then you'll start feeling your right hand, and you feel it. Start feeling it, and you feel your fingers and your wrist and your skin and your elbow and the hand which comes and joins towards your shoulder, and try to feel it. Feel it for 5-10 minutes, maybe then again in afternoon do it, and then again repeat it in evening, and try to feel it again and again, and do it continuously for 3 days whenever it comes up to your mind. And then after 3 days, what is going to happen? You are going to feel enormous energy in this right hand. Enormous energy. Trust me, you are going to feel it. And you are going to feel as if you are blessed with this new hand. And I want you to do it with only one hand, because then you will be able to see the difference in your right and left hand. And then if you want to get that balance, start doing in your left hand also. And do it for 3 days again and again. Your left hand is reborn. Vitality in your left hand. And you'll be more aware of this. So when you are done with this attention of taking your whole attention in your right hand and in your left hand. Why I'm saying for hands? Because hands are more... more sensitive. We keep on working with our hands the whole day, and quarantine is a good period when your hands are so helpful for you. So this is beautiful. And then when it is done, when you are able to learn this activity with taking attention towards something, some part of your body, then start with your buttocks. Sukhasana, maybe Ardha Padmasana. And then take your whole attention on your buttocks. And you should not lean on one side or on other side. Take your whole attention on your buttocks. And try balancing your whole body. And then you are going to feel. Slowly, slowly, when you pay more attention, you will feel more vitality. And you are going to feel more changes. More things happening there. So nothing is happening actually in your buttock. You are centered there. And that is the root chakra, where the energy starts coming up. And slowly you will be able to feel the energy also. So this is a beautiful meditation. A beautiful sutra also. And let me read a few lines from this. When I say centers are not meaningful, but centering is. Whether it happens at the heart or at the head or at the buttocks or anywhere. You have seen Buddha sitting. You may not have imagined that they are balancing their buttocks. You go to a temple and see Mahavira sitting. Buddha sitting. You may never have imagined that this sitting is just a balancing on the buttocks. It is, and when there is no imbalance, suddenly that balance gives you the centering. So again, to get centered, you need to balance the whole body. And even you can see Mahavira standing. The other day also I told you that he stands and then meditates. He balances himself on his legs. So he has taken all his attention on legs. He kept on standing and standing and standing, and suddenly the centering happened. So my friends, I have gone through two sutras today, and soon I am going to post again a guided meditation on YouTube, and then I'll post it on my wall so that you can do it. And this guided meditation will be more regarding the centering technique. I'll use any of the centering technique and then share it later. So it was nice talking to you all. Namaste. I'll be there tomorrow between 10:30 to 10:45 again. Take care.